Hello, fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the Nebraska Cornhuskers and the Illinois Fighting Illini. And before we go any further, let's check in on our star watch, Dick. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
You need your starting five to be the unit who will be intense and also understand what the coach wants early in the game.
And the referee is ready to toss it up.
And the first half is underway, baby.
The Fighting Illini are currently ranked number 25 in the nation, Dick.
Hey, out there, Brad, it's always great to see how the rankings change from week to week. The parity in college basketball is unbelievable.
Inside, tries for two, drains the shot, takes it strong to the hoop.
He knows how to use his strength, Brad. That's such an important skill. You've got to know how to use it without being called for the foul. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Pressure that basketball.
He can't beat the trap.
Are you kidding me? He tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Brad.
10 on the shot clock. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Abrams handles the pass. Looking for a good shot. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. And come up short. On the left side. Nails the J. He's getting lost on every move.
We got to see more heart on defense.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around, fadeaway, off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. Puts up the J. Nope.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He tries the jumper. Knocked it down. Dick, they're really running their offense through the high post right now.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
Gave it up. Gets a hand in the way. We'll stay right here. Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. The Cornhuskers set up in their zone motion. For two, makes the shot.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
For the bucket, gets it to go. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on a perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
Scores it.
Trying to go inside.
He attempts the jump shot. and score it.
Up and inside.
Stripped, active hands.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up. Missed it. Dumps it in. In the lane. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
The jumper. Dick, if you ask me, they're not getting a whole lot of open looks tonight.
They're not moving the ball the way they were taught, Brad.
Inside. Turnaround jumper. He's taking too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Gave it up. Takes his jumper. Knocks it down. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots the jumper. The missed shot. On the wing. They go into the low block. He puts it up and off the mark. Trying to feed the low block. Number one, they spent right now emotionally, Dick.
Hey, he may need some encouragement from one of his teammates. The transition results with a basket.
And we're at the 8-minute mark. Number five handles the pass. Gave it up. Tries for two. He'll want that one back. Goes up for two. Sinks it. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
Well, he spotted an opening, and he just absolutely great first step, and he exploded to the goal.
For two, drains it. They work it around the perimeter. We're at the 7-minute mark. The turn, a fadeaway jumper. Can't connect. Shields receives the pass. Trying to feed inside with the jumper. Missed the jumper.
I saw a play for that hoop. He got the good pass and threw it down, baby.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Jumper won't go. Pushes it up. About 6 minutes remaining. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. nails a sweet jumper. On the left side, he puts up the J. Nope. Tears it away.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
On the right side, he pulls up with a jumper. Nails the jumper. They work it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. And nice looking jumper in the lane. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. For the bucket, it sticks. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Puts up the tray, off the mark. They'll work it around the arc. A little two-man action. Tries for two, off the glass and no good. Four minutes left on the game clock. On the outside. And we'll head back down to the other end. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
I tell you, Brad, he's been awesome, baby. He's a PTP-er. I tell you, what a great performance.
Inbounds play. Both teams looking to get things going here. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
On the outside. Ten to shoot now. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
About 3 minutes remaining. Moving it around the perimeter. For two. Goes. Good find on that back cut, Mr. Vitale.
I tell you, what a great play. That's coaching. That's teaching. That's terrific execution. The back door cut from the weak side.
They look to get it to the inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
They work the perimeter. For the bucket. Got it. About 2 minutes remaining. Throws it up. Tries for two. Jumper. Bust the J. And a momentary look from three-point land. Defense! Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Too strong. One minute left on the game clock. Fed the low block. He tries the jumper and come up short. Wow, partner, this crowd is something else when it gets going.
These fans love it, baby. They're more than a six-man. This crowd is like a whole other team in the stands. This is what college basketball is all about.
Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Gets the J to fall. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo. Look at that spacing.
For two. Gets it to fall. With the big shot, knocked it down. At halftime, the Cornhuskers are trailing by six. Here's a look at what each team here today will be focusing on when we get things underway.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Makes the substitution back into the ballgame.
Well, Brad, it's going to be interesting to see what kind of energy he comes with.
On the dribble, gives it up. With the J, knocks it down. He's going to see this guy in his sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living the nightmare, Brad.
Gave it up. For three. Missed it. Looking for a good shot. Puts up the jumper. Jumper won't go. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Fighting Illini have done a fantastic job of boxing out and rebounding at the defensive end. Dick, you mentioned earlier that this key would be vital to the team's success. So far, so good. However, the coaching staff was also quick to tell the players that only one half of basketball has been played. The great rebounding must continue. Brad?
Thanks, Erin. He attempts the jump shot. Busts the jumper. Goes up with it. Off the mark. There was no doubt about that one.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
On the dribble, gives it up, puts up the J. They got it. Perimeter. Jumper off the mark.
Try to to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
The shooting guard receives the pass. Tries for two. Buried it.
Up and inside.
Goes up. Missed the jumper. Shields handles the feed. Gave it up. Goes up for two. He drains the bucket. The young man cut backdoor and the pass was right on time.
There's nothing like a well-timed backdoor cut and pass. I'm sure they practice that all the time.
With the jumper. The missed shot. The small forward with the ball. Two. Tickles a twine. The student body is rocking tonight.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Down inside. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Can't connect.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For the bucket.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
Dribble, gives it up. With the jumper, gets the J to fall. Gave it up. And the ball is dribbled out of play. The Fighting Illini have really been able to get it done here as a team today, Nick.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really work with one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel it bop.
Now trying to feed the low block. He shoots the jumper. And come up short. On the dribble, gives it up. Lobs it. Tries for two. Trying to pack it inside. Goes up for two. Nope. Working around the perimeter. And it's blocked. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Now let's check back in now on our Star Watch player. Oh, he dribbled the ball out of bounds. inside. He puts up the J. Scores it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
From the corner, knocks it down. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. They're working around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Nails the jumper. Now let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
Gave it up. And the jam.
Got to take some pride on the defensive end.
On the right side. He pulls up with a jumper. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
This is a one-man show right now, Brad. This is supposed to be a team game.
Out on the wing. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For two. Off the mark with that shot. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Down to the low block, trying to work inside. They got it. About 6 minutes remaining on the game clock. They'll work it around the arc. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And sinks it. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up with it. Missed it. The Fighting Illini's are definitely a slow it down type of team, Dick, and they're all about clock management and half court execution.
The moment they get away from this, they aren't as successful.
Gave it up. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. And the block. The shooting guard with the ball. Here they go in transition. Dumps it in. He goes up with it. He misses the jumper.
Try to go inside.
Up with the shot. Missed the jumper. The partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Tate handles the pass. He unloads. He gets it to go. The Fighting Illini have the lead, and time is slowly evaporating, Dick. Being somewhat of a half-court team at this point should really help them out.
Smart teams know that this is crunch time, Brad. Crunch time means that it's time for flawless execution and excellent shot selection.
Alley-oop.
They worked that alley-oop beautifully, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. He looks for three. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
On the outside. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Gave it up. He shoots from downtown. Off the mark. Abrams handles the feed. Dumps it in. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound ability.
On the dribble, gives it up. With the fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Jumper won't go. On the outside. Tries the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
2 minutes left on the game clock. Moving it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Rims out. Nice shot. They work the perimeter.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Shields receives the ball. Inside. Turnaround jumper. And come up short. The Fighting Illini is now looking for a basket in transition. Rejected. And again, they look to run. About a minute remaining. It's stolen. And a momentary look from three-point land. Tries for two. Off the mark with a shot. And he can't hit the shot. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? With a foul. They'll set it up from the baseline. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Sideline inbounds. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
So many teams get bumped on screens when you inbounds the ball from the baseline.
From the corner. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if you were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots. It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
The Cornhuskers set up in their zone motion. He shoots from the corner. He seems to block. His shot's blocked.
Hey, he thought he spotted space in that zone. Not today, baby.
another solid junior.
Hey, I'll tell you, juniors and seniors are valuable pieces in any college basketball puzzle. Having experienced kids like this on the court and on the bench can take a lot of pressure off the coaching staff.
Gets it. Time to pick up the defense here now. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Looking for a good shot. Caught in quite a battle tonight before pulling ahead for good.
They came in the favorites, and they did not disappoint.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.